are by the Sea of Galilee, climbing fences to sleep by the sea. In recent years, they've gated off this area because they don't want people sleeping here, but we're doing it anyway. So we arrive at this campsite, which is on the edge of the sea, which is absolutely amazing. I don't really know what it looks like because we got here at night, so we set up camp at night. So we're gonna pause, we're gonna regroup, we're gonna rest. So we'll see how it goes. After an incredible evening experience of trying to find a secluded campsite, we ended up here. Just the land, it's very calm, it's very peaceful, it's very green, it's very lush in this area. And the Sea of Galilee is very calming, relaxing. There's this energetic of home, a hominess. To the Basilica of the Transfiguration, which is where Jesus was on the mountain with his crew, and then he went into a meditation and had the visions, or as they say in the Bible, Moses and Elijah, the prophets, came to talk to him and let him know what part of his mission was, and that he would actually die and resurrect. And that's the first time that he hears this news, because after that he starts speaking about it and his boys don't understand what he's talking about, because he starts talking and saying, oh, after I'm resurrected, and they don't understand what he's talking about. So he actually, if we don't believe that Moses and Elijah came to him, he actually prophesied his own death and resurrection. So, of course, these are all great stories. Do we choose to believe them? That's what makes you Christian or not. State-of-the-art pastry place in Nazareth. Just opened. We're going to head to Mount Tabor, the site of the Transfiguration. More on that to come. Transfiguration. They can't state for sure whether it happened here or not, because it's a bit inaccurate in terms of where exactly it happened. Behind me chapel. And what I find very interesting is the symbolism of the triangle and the all-seeing eye, with the light emanating from it. Could it mean the third eye, the oneness, the all-seeing eye? It's amazing that it's actually depicted in a church. So I just did a meditation in this space specifically, practiced some breath work that I learned with Avishag, and very, very powerful. Again, definitely this whole mountain, like I was saying, is a power site. I just feel it. I feel it in my chest. I feel it in my solar plexus chakra through the meditation. Again, gagging reflex. More beauty, more love, more land, more green, more shouting from the top of our lungs. Yes, more. This trip involves a lot of hiking. I haven't stopped walking since I arrived in Paris. Exhausted, because I've been working hard. And then when I got here in Israel, I've been walking uphill. I've been walking uphill for days. My legs and butt are in pain. They're on fire as usual, but it's good. It means I'm gonna have
the life of a pilgrim.
It's true. I'm seeing it as I'm working out my butt. Watch out, Montreal, because when I get home, my butt's gonna be hot. Here with Frank Mondeose, and this is the spiritualplayboy.com. Enjoy the view and let love free. Peace. Nutella time. Nutella.